had some technical difficulties with their cameras, so that they could see what's going on stage. So we apologize, but thank you and welcome to our final drama and dance show of the year. We appreciate you coming out to see us and to support all of our wonderful students. I'm Cheryl. I think I've met most of you.
And I'm Paige, and I've met most of you too. So
we just have a couple of quick announcements.
So in the back page of your program, we have listed the fourth Fridays that we're going to be open for community art, and that's in all ages, all of youth abilities. So I don't want to hear that anybody didn't come because they don't know how to do it. We're going to teach, and it's going to be fun. And then this Wednesday, June 1st, right, from 5 to 6, the visual art class is going to have all of their artwork, not all of it, but most of their artwork on display. So we'll be open, like I said, from 5 to 6, welcoming anyone to come in and look.
Monday, June 6th, game day slash graduation ceremony.
Yeah, so we're going to be open Monday, June 6th. That will be our last day, and it's going to be game day, and it's open for the 6th, 7th, and 8th grader, all no matter what class they've taken. So it's going to be an end of the year celebration, and our last term is 6th grade.
Stop. I know. I might cry tonight because a lot of the 8th graders have been with us since they were in 6th grade, so we've been working with them for 3 long, really awesome years. You guys have awesome kids. The new ones too that are 6th and 7th grade, so let's applaud them.
And one more is there's no school on Monday, so we will not have a program on Monday also.
Yes. So one other thing is just our summer program. Actually, two other things. Summer program, we still have a few spots open. Registration is through June 1st. There will be a 7-minute intermission. And so at that time, we have some registration forms available there. There are full and partial scholarships available. The camps this summer are improv, which is very similar to the last improv show that some of you saw, acting on the spot. Rags to Riches, we're going to be learning how to take old clothes and clothes from thrift stores to alter them into new looks. And there'll be a fashion show at the end of the week from that. And then Rock Band Camp, which is where students learn how to be in a rock band. Oh, I see a potential rock band camp back there. it's a lot of fun. You don't have to have any music experience at all. It's for students 6th through 8th grade. Drums, guitar, bass, vocals, everything. And all the equipment is provided. We rehearse with professional musicians at Outpost Music across the street.
And actually, it's for students going into 6th grade through going into 9th grade.
That's right. Yep, so entering 6th through 9th grade. And then, one really cool thing is we perform at Blues Fest in Delafield, Wisconsin at the end of the week. And that's really special. So we hope that you will sign your kids up. And I'll be available during the intermission to ask questions, as will anybody who doesn't capture. Alright, so that being said, we're going to go ahead and get started. We have 2 people out sick in the first play, so Luke will be playing the role, actually reprising his role. He played this role last year in Remake Is a Pleasure, Harlan Pepperswell. And then Sandra, who's actually Julia's older sister, will be stepping in for her this evening. So let's give them a quick round of applause. And without further ado, we're going to go ahead and start. Thank you.
Send the reporter in. President of the Fifth National Bank is always happy to meet the press. Sit down. This is the bank with the wall-to-wall money. I'm the man who lends it with a smile.
Yes, sir. I was thinking of dressed up like Santa Claus. He runs toward the bank. Hope just can't wait to loan money. Hope doesn't really care if you ever pay it back.
Except that the law forces you to pay it back. Alas, Santa Claus, eh?
Everybody knows who Santa Claus is in the town. They're always so kind, eager, and determined to loan you some money.
Not a bad idea. I'll have my tailor make me a single-breasted Santa Claus suit with stretch pants and a beard to match.
Great. I'll call you up in a week or two, and I'll make an appointment with the photographer.
You sure you don't need any money?
No, thanks. Like all newspaper reporters, you're vastly overpaid. Well, I might take a small sample to show my friends. Mr. Pepperstall!
Good afternoon. I'm Mrs. Khan. Remember me? Oh, I'm so thrilled. It is an option I speak with May present. Have you ever thought of starting a fan club?
Sit down and be calm, Mrs. Khan. Fan club? Well, many of our borrowers are aware of my modesty, my generosity, my virtue, my vision, my wisdom, and my natural charm. I've always wanted to form a fan club, but I believe it'd be undignified. I think our customers are happy enough with free balloons, lollipops, thermometer shirts, and candy canes, pony rides. And what is your pleasure, Mrs. Conk? This month, with each loan, we are adding a set of genuine English bone chinaware made from indestructible translucent plastic.
I hate to mention, but I've been so extravagant since you gave me the last loan.
Good. Keeps the economy thriving. Live beyond your means and keep America free.
Remember I borrowed $4,000 for a new car? Well, two trees and a guardrail ran into it.
The mayor ought to do something about that. But don't worry, the car probably needs washing and greasing. So I'm going to buy a new one. Why not take $10,000 and buy two new ones? Why not make it $30,000 and buy a new house, too?
I could use a new house. The old money's
paying. Just sign this and give it to the teller. They'll credit your account with $30,000 less $16,000 interest and give you green stamps, lollipops, plastic cups, and a smoking bear hat.
I suppose I'll have to pay this all back someday.
Why worry? Take 40 years to pay. It's only money.
Thank you so much. You're a good man.
Mr. Pepperstall! Call me Homer! I need money! I throw it away, burn the hole in my pocket, never can save a nickel.
I like people who throw away money. It keeps the economy at a high level.
I buy crazy stuff on the installment plan. Bought an ocean liner last month, complete with staff, life belt, and a shuffleboard! Toot-toot! Woman and children first! Man overboard!
Without installment buying, people would have to be satisfied for what they could afford. Now billions of dollars is about things we can't afford. Go beyond your means and keep America free.
I also paid a few $1,000 for advanced cha-cha lessons. Look! Beautiful stuff.
Money well spent. How much do you want?
$10,000, $20,000.
That doesn't seem to be enough for a man of your taste. Take $30,000 and get a free trip to Sun Valley. Hello? Main floor entertainment area? Miss Google? Dancing with a customer in the vault? Splendid! How about Miss Cuddle? Just finished her act in the Christmas club window? Fine. Have her send Tony down and come in herself. We like to keep our customers entertained while they think about their loans. Miss Cuddle, are you coming down?
Ah, Miss Cuddle!
Tony, can you please give Mr. Job a light trim while I think about borrowing some money? fresh fig tree on the mezzanine? Well, have him come in here and give a customer a shoe shine, eh? Oh, passing out candy apples and soap bubble sets? Well, don't disturb him. Well, do you want the money? I'll throw it away on my trip to Pago Pago.
How will I get it back to pay you?
I'll make it round trip.
That's better. Don't take any off the top. Can you pep it up a bit, sister? I have an idea. I'd like to start my own business.
Splendid. Shows an imaginative spirit.
I was thinking of the frozen whale meat business. Do you know that one whale, can produce several hundred whale steaks? Not to mention short ribs and whale bones.
I don't see how you can miss.
Do you want it wet or dry?
Leave it the way it is.
Will 50,000 be enough to start?
It's better than nothing.
Good. Just sign here. Take it to the teller and get your money, less a slight interest charge. You'll also get a free statue of Benjamin Franklin and a color TV, plus a 10 transmitter radio, and of course thousands of green stamps, candy apples, balloons, blotters, and 6 free rides at the Thunderbolt at Riverside Parks next summer.
Perfect. Thank you. You're the kind of patron America needs, a man with a heart.
Knock it off, kids. And send in the chief bookkeeper $10,000 in pennies. Bill, it's time you learned the value of money. I kept you here 3 nights with only bread and water, hoping you would find that 6-cent deficit you showed. This is serious, Bill. It was only 6 cents, but it could have easily been $6 billion.
I'll pay it out of my own pocket. I'll do anything, anything.
You will stay here and go through every single penny, setting aside all the Lincoln heads marked with D and minted in 1907. You will select those in which Lincoln's beard is not fully grown and the ones where he is wearing sunglasses.
But that'll take forever.
Bill, I am fond of you. I've been a father and a mother to you. I've raised your salary in the last 9 years all of it to $58 a week. And you have only one wife and 6 children to support. Small children at that, Bill. You must learn the value of money.
I've had enough.
What's that? Rebellion?
I noticed in figuring that one of your loans one day, that the interest on $10,000 comes to about $30,000. And in that case, a small loan spends about 162% a year.
That's banking. I consider high interest rates the very foundation of capitalism. There is something splendid about 162%. You have before us a rebel, a man who does not believe in the free enterprise. Throw him out!
I go bravely!
No, other window. Did he get hurt?
How do I know? He hasn't landed yet.
My order. You said you wanted to see. strange, very strange. So that was one double cheeseburger minus onions, correct?
Yes.
Did you want pickles?
I only cut the onions.
What, pickles and lettuce?
Yes.
Tomato.
How many times did I have to tell you to only cut the onions?
Well, I didn't want to mess up your order. Some customers can get very unhappy. Thanks.
Tell me, do I look unhappy?
Yes.
That's what I'm answering. All of your dumb questions.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to get your order right.
And you got it right. Right?
I believe so. Oh, do you want to order an apple pie for a dollar just for today?
No.
They're on sale, but only for today.
No.
So that's a double cheeseburger with lettuce, tomatoes, pickles, and the onions.
Yes.
Did you want fries?
How many times do you have to go through this?
But how can you refuse crispy, salty?
Listen here, I don't want fries.
It's your decision, says it may be. But tell me, do you like fries?
That is not the point here.
Because you're like the only person who's coming here today and has not ordered fries.
Well, maybe someone tried to order fries, but then you made them feel guilty until they did order fries.
Never mind that.
To make customers feel guilty?
Oh, so fries.
Well, you didn't score me enough, did you?
Then you said no to that apple pie.
Yes.
Yes?
No.
Yes?
No. Don't want an apple pie.
Yes, well, what is it? They're only on sale for today.
That's it, I've had it. Just get me my order.
No apple pie.
No apple pie.
No.
No.
Okay, I think I can get it.
Thank you.
One double cheeseburger, cut the onions.
Yes, that's it.
I think you want fries with that.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, I will take fries.
All right, I'll be right back with you.
And I'll take an apple pie too.
Okay.
Thank you.
That's it? You didn't go look for work?
When they want me, they'll send for me. I'm perfectly happy waiting.
But I'm not, and my wife is not.
You know how it is with me and work. Too heavy for light work, too light for heavy work. Most jobs are too dull. Others are too interesting. They raise my blood pressure. The ones in between are too in between. I have trouble sleeping days because I take naps in the morning and the afternoon. I can't work nights because that's when I sleep.
Applefield, this house isn't big enough for all of us.
I'll be sorry to see her go.
She's not going. You're going. It's her house.
Then you lied to me. 10 years ago, you asked me here for the weekend.
And you stayed for 10 years?
Sure, but I remember clearly. When I started to go one day, you said stay as long as you'd like.
Oh, all right. We'll talk about this later. Look, my boss is coming here. Please try to be alert. And no stale jokes. My boss is a serious woman. She's the head of my department and a great engineer.
I won't say a word. You know how I am.
That's what I'm worried about.
Couldn't you go for a walk when Mr. Smith comes, George?
I just took a bath. You want me to get pneumonia?
It's hot out.
You want me to get prickly heat?
Nobody ever died of prickly heat. Not yet.
Is that what you want? My picture in a medical textbook. First man ever to die of prickly heat.
All right. Just dump it. There's the door.
Glad to see you, Mr. Smith. This is Brother George.
Nice knowing you. Say, do you know the difference between a collision and an explosion?
No, Bill. In the explosions can move things a little bit too much to the left, or the manic.
In a collision, you know where you are. But in an explosion, where are you?
You can go in the automated section of the plant right here. The memory base will start to destroy an object.
Here's a hot one. A traveling salesman noticed a farmer feeding his hog with a teaspoon. The traveler said, won't that take a long time to fatten a hog that way? The farmer said, sure, but what's time to a hog?
Now you notice we stay like the body.
No sense of humor at all. You forgot one big thing. Women hate to back up in an automobile. They always hit something, right? Right. So lots of women won't buy a car because they're scared to back up. I once had a girl who used to park a little ahead of the parking space and had to ask for help from pedestrians. The third time she did it, a charming fellow backed the car right into the next state.
George! The geranium needs watering.
Huh? The geranium? That's plastic. This is my design for a car with a steering wheel, headlights, and brakes, in back as well as in front. A woman wants to back up, she just gets to the other end of the car and drives from there. Like the old-fashioned trolley cars, they can be steered from either end. You drive past the line, you just get to the other end of the car and drive forward.
A splendid notion, of course.
They can be smoothed out. If it works, we can sell millions of cars to women who can't back up. We'll prevent injuries to people they bump into. And trees. We'll save a lot of trees.
I'm going right back to the plant to study this. You never can tell. There may just be a germ or something.
I'll go with you.
My great brakes fit like my pants. Who's going to promote me? Then that moron had to come up with this crazy notion. Drive backwards? What about the rear seats? They have to face backwards. And what if somebody grab the rear steering wheel while you were trying to drive?
Yes, while you were driving frontwards.
It's crazy. 10 years. 10 long, horrible years.
10 weary, heartbreaking years.
I'd have taken him and thrown him out bodily long ago if he wasn't your brother.
My brother? I always thought he was your brother.
We have three dances that we're doing. One is a salsa dance. We have a professional ballroom dancer.
come in for 2 days for a half hour each day to work with the girls on a salsa dance. That'll be their first dance. Their second dance is they got to pick their favorite dance of the year, which they chose the Missy Elliott dance, so that hip hop dance. And the third is my favorite. It's from the musical Annie, Hard Knock Life. And we have a guest actor for that, Magdalena Dudek. Some of you might know her. As well as Miss Hannigan, so that's very exciting. So that'll be first. And then after the dance performance, we'll have a show called Can't Get Here From There. Quiet backstage. And then our last show is very special because we have four actors in that show that when their very first show when they came here when they were in sixth grade, they played the roles that they are going to do today. And so that is very special, and I even have a little video to do a blast from the past of when they were in sixth grade to embarrass them. So it's amazing to see how they've come so far in 3 years. So we'll go ahead and start with our dance performance. So.
you. Get up. Get up. Turn around. I said turn around. Now what do you say? What do you say?
We love you, Miss Hornicorn.
Rotten orphan. Your parents left you here. That was in 1922. It is now 1933. And for your shenanigans, you will get on your naughty little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
Why anybody would ever want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
Are we on Route 62C?
Can't say.
Are we far from the 278B?
Don't know.
Does the road to Hudson Fall run the back of your place here?
Don't know, but look.
We're nearly out of gas. Is there a filling station nearby?
Don't know.
Well, is there any place we can stay the night in town?
Can't rattle say.
How far is it from here to the New York State Line?
I don't know.
Are we anywhere near the Massachusetts Turnpike?
Don't know.
You don't know much, do you?
No. But I'm not lost.
By him, no longer will he have to spend sleepless nights worrying about his bills. He could take a trip to Paris and meet some beautiful girls.
You rascal!
His share of a million was... Well, Henry, what was it?
I was just guilty of working illegally.
Let us say it was in here of... $100,000.
Oh, what did you do with it, Henry?
Yes, Henry, where is it? Make restitution in 5 or 10 years and be cut off your sentence.
Just a parking ticket. It says here, look, charged with illegal parking. Appear in court and pay the $2 and...
So you were planning to leave your lovely wife? Your wife who has always been tender and warm-hearted to you.
Don't forget, has given the best years of her life to you.
Thank you. Who has given the best years of her life to you. Planning to skip to Paris with $100,000.
It's just a parking ticket.
Your Honor, I asked my client to be tried before a jury.
Well, this court is corrupt in every respect.
I don't want a jury trial.
Very well! He waives his right to a jury, and I haven't had such a peachy one in dog's age. Imagine $1 million bank robbery! In the view of the habeas corpus, the liber mortis, the corpus habeas, the spiritus fermenti, the omnia gallia, the e pluris omnum, I sentence you to 5 to 10 years in the state single cell prison! Take him away!
Do you play baseball? They need a shortstop at the same time.
Your Honor!
This case is closed. Can't imagine how nerve-wracking these things can be.
This is wonderful.
Wonderful!
Of course.
Well, appeal. We'll take it to the highest court in the land. And how proud to be, Mrs. Smith. Your husband's picture is in all papers, with you as the little woman who's faithfully waiting for him.
The little woman to whom he owes everything.
He can probably be on TV quiz shows, soap commercials, maybe even a Senate investigation.
I've always wanted to see the cherry trees in Washington.
Judge, I am innocent!
You said you were guilty.
I'm guilty, but I'm innocent!
All right, I'll be a big heart. I'll release you on $50,000 bail.
Where would I get it?
Out of the $100,000 you stole!
The parking ticket, the meter, the nickel light!
The case is closed.
The court is adjourned.
That's what I like. A day in court where everything is just and precise. Nothing forgotten, no loose ends, nothing untidy.
Woo!
I have to. I need 1 minute to get this going. We have the video from when they did this when they were sixth graders. So if you can believe it, this was going to be 3 years ago. If you want to,
you feel free to walk on the stage.
Yes, you can walk on the stage. I have all of the eighth graders come on stage with me. Everybody else off. Okay,
Oh my gosh, 2 years and 1 year in the prank, because you guys were really awesome. Thank you guys so much for coming. I'm sorry for falling apart.